Yeah, let's do that.
You should do jiu-jitsu, man.
I've been thinking about it.
Fuck yeah, man. Get in there. I love it.
A lot of anxiety going through my head. I've been thinking about it. My problem is I'm not around anywhere. I don't know.
You can take it on the road.
I'd be the fucking punching bag every.
Yeah.
I'd be Daniel's son every day.
Yeah, it's good for you. It's good for you to get your ass kicked.
Really?
Yeah, it's good for you to know how easy it is for a man to kick your ass too. It's
good
for you. It's good for you to get destroyed. It's good for you to get mounted and triangle choked and shit. It's good because you realize how easy it is for someone to do that to you. Because most people have no idea. They walk through this world having no idea
how
100%. Some Marcelo Garcia character could just fucking take your life anytime he wanted to. And not just take your life. How about this? How about take my life? How about I've been doing jiu-jitsu since 96, and that little dude from Brazil could strangle the fuck out of me any day he wants. That's reality. And I'm almost a black belt. I'm like high level. There's a lot of people I've choked out. I can choke out some good people, man. And that guy could just tap me anytime he wants. So for me to be like almost a black belt, I might as well have never done jiu-jitsu. I'll just be able to hold him off for a little. He's going to get me. It's inevitable.
Yeah.
That's the kind of reality that exists for most people if you know jiu-jitsu. For most people, if you're in some sort of a street altercation with someone and you get a hold of them, that's all you have to do.
Yeah.
That's all you have to do. Hang on. Because you know what? In class, you're going 100%. 100%.
Are you serious?
Yeah. You know why? Because you don't hit each other. You're trying to choke and grappling. And in grappling, you're allowed to go 100%. It doesn't mean you hurt your partners. If you have a lock or if you have a choke, you put it to a certain position and you can just hold it and let it go. But the point is, it takes 100% of your effort to get to that position. And that's exactly what's going to come up in a fight. In a fight, it's going to be 100% effort, except you're used to doing 100% effort 3-4 nights a week.
Yeah.
3-4 nights a week. I go and there's grown men and they're going to try to kill me with their bare hands and I'm going to try to kill them. And then we're going to slap hands and we hug and I say, thanks, brother. And we move on to the next guy. And you go to the next one. The next one, you tap hands. You slap hands. That's what everybody does. And then you lock up. And this is the goal. I'm going to try to get you to tap. And what you're saying when you tap is, you could have just killed me. And then you're going to try to do the same thing to me. And if you get me in something, I'm going to have to tap. And I'm not going to want to, but I'm going to have to, because it's very important. You don't want to die.
That's a missed opportunity in my life right there.
Just do it.
Henzo
Gracie?
Henzo was told me, he was like, come on out to the place and I will we'll teach you jiu-jitsu.
Sure.
And
why don't you do it? It's a game. And the game is using your body to dominate another person's body with technique and leverage.
I want to do it. I want to do it because I have so many anxieties of just... It's the reason I want to get a fucking massive dog.
Yeah.
It's the reason I want to fucking live in Montana. It's the reason I want to buy a shotgun every time I'm in Iowa.
Right.
It's like it's the reason I drink on planes. I just am afraid,
You're afraid of a fight on a plane?
Today, yeah. fucking guy in fucking jumpsuit.
How many, by the way, before we get started, how many fucking fight stories have ever been started by this fucking guy?